Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making whoopie pies for Valentine's Day. Now, whoopie pie is just a sandwich cookie, a large sandwich cookie. So we will need two cookies, and they're usually chocolate, and we will sandwich a marshmallow filling in between them. So let's start by making the cookies. We'll need a large bowl, and into that bowl we're going to put one stick of softened butter. Now I put this in the microwave, so it's a little beyond softened. It's actually about right in its texture, but it did go liquid a little bit. But that is 1/2 cup, which is the same as one stick of butter. And to that we're adding 1 cup of dark brown sugar that is firmly packed. There we go. Now it's nice and supple. We'll be using our mixer. We're going to mix this on low until it's just blended. Then we're going to mix for 3 minutes. Now I scrape down the sides occasionally, but this is what I have after beating on high for 3 minutes. It's really nice and smooth. You're trying to get that consistency. Next, add 1 whole egg. And also add 1 teaspoon of vanilla. Then I'll remove my spoon here, put the mixer back in, and I'm going to beat for 2 minutes. I'll start on low and then go to high for 2 minutes. Again, I've been scraping down the sides during this process, and this is when I have finished my 2 minutes of beating with the egg and vanilla added. So now we're going to some dry ingredients. I have a small bowl over here. Into that bowl, I'm putting 1 1/2 cups of all-purpose flour. To that, I'm adding 2/3 cup of cocoa powder. It's going to be nice and chocolatey. This is 1 1/2 teaspoons of baking soda. And then I have 1 teaspoon of salt. And I'll just use a little spoon to stir that together because we want a mixture that is homogeneous. I have 1 1/4 cups of milk. And I need to add that into my beaten mixture, and I plan to do that half of the dry ingredients and then half of the milk, just roughly. And then I will beat and then repeat that for the other half. I'm scraping the bowl down one last time, and you can see what we have here from the mixing. It's a lovely mixture, and the texture is somewhere between cake batter and cookie dough. It's more like cake batter, I would say. But anyway, we're going to put these on baking pans that have been lined with parchment paper. And I'm going to use a scoop to get those out, and this scoop measures a little over 2 tablespoons. And you really want about 1 tablespoon, so I'm just going to get less than the entire amount and try to be consistent with what I get out each time and place that on my parchment paper. And I would like to take my fingers and put some flour on them so that I can touch this. It's really very sticky anyway. But I want to press it down just a little bit, because I don't want these to be too mounded up. Actually, you may want to make them a little smaller than that. But these will spread, so the next one should be over here. So I'll continue to place these on the parchment paper, and I'll show you the resulting cookies or cakes before they go in the oven. Here I have 2 pans ready to go in the oven. I put 8 in the first pan because it was fairly large. This is 15 by 10 by 1 inch. And you can use a pan like that. You can use the Pyrex dish or anything that you can bake with in the oven. And you may have to put fewer, or you may be able to fit more in. This one was a smaller pan, and I put 6 in there. And you can see the flour still on the top. That was so I would have the ability to keep them from making circular cakes. They're going to be flat and hopefully all the same height when they are baked up. I did have some batter left over, and you can see that if I had had more space in my pans, I could have probably put four more in there. So what I have is one pan of 8 and one pan of 6. I'm getting 14, but this probably would have made 18 easily of the size I chose. Now these go to a 375 degree oven, and we'll bake them with me testing all along to see if they're done, and I will tell you how long I bake them. I just got the whoopie pies out of the oven, or the pie part at least, and they baked for 10 minutes at 375 degrees. Your test for doneness, instead of using a toothpick test, although that would work, is just to treat it like a cake, and if you press on it, it should spring back. If it actually leaves a big imprint, then it's not done yet. What we're going to do is let them stay in the pans for about 5 minutes and cool. And then we're going to use spatula, get them out of the pans and put them on cooling racks and let them cool completely, because we know that that luscious marshmallow filling goes in the center and we want to make them cool enough that it will stay firm. While the pie part of our whoopie pie is cooling, I'm going to make the filling. And it's a marshmallow filling, and I mentioned that earlier, I think. I'm using marshmallow cream. Now, you don't need all of that, but what you need is 3/4 cup. So I have that measured out in one of these push-through measuring cups. So there we go, and it's sticking to the bottom, so we'll just get that off. You need to put that in a large mixing bowl and add to that some butter. Here we have 10 tablespoons of butter, and I've softened it to room temperature. Now we're going to beat this on medium speed for a couple of minutes. Then we have 1/2 tablespoon of vanilla to add, and also we have 1/2 cup of confectioner sugar. Now that's the same as powdered sugar or icing sugar. So beat that in on low at the beginning, and then go to medium speed and beat it for about 3 minutes, or until it's really smooth. Now this is a moderate amount of filling because I tailored it to my family, and we don't like to have a lot of sugary things, and this is going to be very sugary. But if you like your filling to be very thick between the two pie parts of the whoopie pie, then you could double each element in this recipe and have twice as much here, and some people would want that much to do their filling. This is ready except for the fact that I'm doing this for Valentine's Day and I just have to make it red. So I have my gel food coloring. That is the quickest way to get a deep red, and I'm just going to squirt a few blobs in there, and then I'm going to stir first. And then I want to make sure it makes really good contact everywhere when I have what I've determined to be the right amount. I don't want it just pink. I think I'll add some more. And this is looking pretty nice, but I think we'll take it a little farther than that because it needs to be something that really will remind you of Valentine's Day instead of maybe just thinking that's a nice Easter color. So this is probably going to do it. So I'm going to use my mixer. We finished our mixing and we're ready to do our spreading. So I have my 1/2 whoopie pies over here. Each one of these is 1/2. We have 14 altogether, so that will make 7 complete whoopie pies. And as I said, you can make more because I did have some batter left over. Let's pick 2 that are about the same size, and I can use 1/7 of this filling if I want to use it all for this purpose. If I want to bake up the others, then I should go a little light on it. And it's very creamy. It's going to have that nice marshmallow flavor and also has a bit of buttercream flavor. And I think we're ready to put the top on. So we'll go like this. And there we have our finished whoopie pie for Valentine's Day. I'm going to spread up the rest of them, and then I'll let you see me take a bite. You might have noticed that I have flour on the top of these. That was from me putting flour on my fingertips and pressing them down to give them a good flat start. If you don't like the look of flour there at the end, what you can do is use some confectioner sugar, and it's a good touch anyway to just sprinkle that fairly evenly over the top of these, and that gives you a little bit of garnish. Here are our finished whoopie pies for Valentine's Day, and I'm going to take a bite for you. So let me put this down, and I'll just grab one like this one right here and put it in my plate. And I'm going to take a knife and cut through so you can see what the inside looks like. I'll just cut it across this way. It's nice and cakey. So if you think of these as cookies, think of them as cake-like cookies. I think it's more cake than it is pie, but the traditional name is whoopie pie, and traditionally this is white marshmallow filling inside. So this may have a tendency to be a little problem because of color and getting it on your fingers or getting it on your mouth or whatever, but you know me, I'll take a chance. So let's take a little bite. Flavor is great. I'd like to tell you what the chocolate itself tastes like. It's very dark and rich. So if you don't like chocolate that rich, just cut down on the amount of cocoa powder that you put in. It'll be fine. But I love it. I really like it exactly like this. And I like the taste of the filling. I don't think I can isolate it, but it's nice and sweet, not overly sweet. In fact, the chocolate is strong enough that it kind of takes in that sweetness and blends together and gives a just wonderful dessert flavor. I think you'll enjoy making this. If you want to make something for your sweetheart, just look at them and you know that they say love because they are different than the normal whoopie pie.